Welcome to the new episode of WhatsApp program. Today we have a very special guest in our studio, Mr. Stephen Lecce. He's a young politician. During the last elections, he was elected as MPP from King Vaughan riding, and now he is a Parliament assistant to Minister of Infrastructure, and also he is special assistant to our Premier Doug Ford. Mr. Stephen Lecce, welcome to our studio.
Thank you so much for having me. It's my pleasure.
Okay. So Mr. Ford's government has completed 1 year recently. Many promises were made. What do you think? How could the government achieve or any biggest achievement of the government during this last 1 year?
I think the single greatest achievement of our government is on the economy. We campaigned with a focus on lowering taxes, creating private sector jobs, and unleashing the economic potential of people and small businesses in the province. After 15 years, and I say this respectfully to the former Premier Kathleen Wynne and Dalton McGuinty, we saw our economy and our families take a hit. Incomes were the slowest rising in the country. We have an unemployment rate for young people that is twice the national average. Young people can't afford homes. You know the problems as well as I do. The focus today should be maybe more on the solutions. And I really want to make the case that in the first year, we have really, I think, just started to see the success. We have created the conditions for over 190,000 private sector jobs, overwhelmingly full-time jobs, overwhelmingly good-paying jobs in the province of Ontario, helping people in the 905, in the GTA, in Brampton, in Vaughan, in communities across Ontario, and for young people to get good jobs related to their skills. So mission number one was grow the economy. We are leading the nation in economic growth. We lead the nation in job creation. Over 50% of jobs created in this nation are created right here in Ontario, and I'm proud that we are doing all the things that create the conditions for jobs and for business to grow. I think we are helping to ensure our businesses have a competitive advantage. That's the big reason why we oppose Justin Trudeau's carbon tax. We think the Prime Minister imposing a tax on families, on seniors, on fixed income for middle-class people, but also on our business sector, puts them at a disadvantage compared to our trading partners around us. So we're fighting for the taxpayer. We're making this economy work for everyone, and we're bringing people up. And I think that's a very positive thing. And it motivates me going into year two, because we need to do a lot more to really ensure that the best days of this province are ahead of us.
Okay, there are some unpopular decisions also. There are allegations that government is on cuts in the families and in the healthcare sector, cuts in the education sector. What do you think about that?
Well, look, I think, you know, I've heard that narrative, and it's a convenient narrative for the conservatives, but it's not an accurate one, because I think when you look at the numbers, you mentioned healthcare, that in healthcare alone, the Minister of Health, the Deputy Premier, talk about a priority for the Premier of Ontario to make his health minister, Christine Elliott, the Deputy Premier, is investing an additional $1.3 billion to make our healthcare system work, to ensure that at Brampton Civic and at hospitals across Ontario, that no longer do you have to get healthcare in a hallway, which is a legacy of the Liberals. I mean, we believe that we're making those investments. We're adding over $250 million in home care, so that for seniors that need care in their homes, we're making it more accessible, more dependable. Mental health is a big priority for my family and for many people, I'm sure many of your viewers. Mm-hmm. You know, we want to end the stigma. We want especially young people on campuses to get the support they need. Right now, when we came to power, a young person on a college university would wait 18 months to see a counselor. Totally unacceptable. And as you know, sometimes time can mean, you know, it could be very critical in the context of someone's life.
And so, you were talking about the carbon tax. So government is confronting with the federal government. We were hearing today that mostly Canadians, they want to bring some improvement in the climate change, a big issue for the country.
Yeah.
Yes, they are not willing to pay the taxes for that. So how the government is dealing with this issue?
To your last question, to this question, I think the commonality is we're making the investments necessary. In healthcare, we're making new investments. We're building 60 new hospitals or renovating existing ones. On the environment, we're investing in the protection of our land, our water, and our air. We believe climate change is real, and I believe as a younger politician, a young conservative, that we need to make sure that our environment is protected for the next generation. Just like I believe we should protect the economy for the next generation, we shouldn't leave our kids with debt, economic debt, we shouldn't leave them with ecological debt. Now, the Liberals, as you know, left us with a very large deficit and large debt, so we have a lot of heavy lifting to do, a lot of tough decisions. We believe we have to do more to reduce our emissions, but Ontario is the leader in the nation on emission reductions. We've reduced emissions by 22%. We're almost at the finish line when it comes to meeting our Paris targets. What we disagree with Prime Minister Trudeau, respectfully, is that raising taxes on middle-income families, on single moms, on low-income seniors, on pensioners, is not a responsible environmental policy. It's simply a tax grab, and it's a way to increase monies for the state. So we are fighting that. We do not believe that a mom or dad bringing their children to school should be punished because they drive their kids to school, or drive themselves to work, or you go get groceries. Everything is going up as a consequence of this carbon tax, and yet emissions are not going down. And so we believe you could protect the environment while also protect the economy, and you shouldn't have to make them competing priorities. We believe environmental protection and economic growth go hand in hand, and we're investing to do both.
Okay, poll surveys are telling us that the popularity of the government has come down. Are you agree to that, or how you take that?
You know, I always think that the only poll that ultimately matters is the one on election day. I know you've heard this before, but at the end of the day, look, in government, you know, we're going to make decisions that people will like, some decisions they will like less. That's just the ebb and flow of politics. I'm not going to be, you know, too fixated on polls. I care about following through on our commitments. And we campaigned to reduce the deficit so we can live within our means, just like your viewers do at home every day. We have to balance our budgets. We campaigned to grow the economy. We campaigned to invest in healthcare and to make sure that our young people could achieve their potential. We're doing all those things. And I think it's important politicians of all stripes follow through on their word. And Doug Ford is a politician who's doing that. We've already fulfilled over two-thirds of our campaign commitments in 1 year, which is really an incredible amount of speed. We introduced more legislation in the last year than any government has in 30 years, just to contextualize that we really take our responsibilities seriously. And Doug Ford works hard. Our government is working hard. You know, in Peel, we've got very strong members of provincial parliament, in Brampton, Mississauga, and right across Ontario, people who are adding value, who are fighting for their communities. And look, I think what's important is we stay true to our commitments we made to the people and to our own conscience. And for me, knowing that we're creating jobs, knowing that we're creating economic opportunity, know that we're investing in healthcare, for me is very rewarding, and I think there's more work to do, and that's why I'm looking forward to working over the summer and through the fall to continue to deliver for the people, deliver lower taxes and opportunity.
Okay. Last government announced some funding for university in Brampton. That was one of the biggest demands of Bramptonians. The funding was taken back by the government right after they sworn in. So what is the status of the university? What do you think that? Will Brampton get the university?
Yeah, I just think it's important to remember when that happened. The former Liberals were in power for 15 years. And for 15 years, they did not invest in post-secondary institutions in Brampton. And then months before the election, without any money allocated for that commitment, they announced a university in Brampton. And so it's easy to make announcements. Look, it's easy to write checks, as you know, personally, in government and business. It's difficult to, you know, have to make those difficult decisions to live within one's means. So I appreciate that they made the commitment in the final months on the back of a napkin. No one really believed that it was going to get done. There is truth that Brampton has a very fast-growing population, young community here. It's a beautiful community, diverse. That's why we're building new schools in Brampton. It's why we're extending the 427 in the west, on the east side of Brampton. It's why we're doing a lot, I think, to support healthcare investments in Brampton and Brampton Civic. With that said, you know, the student population, university population is reducing in Ontario, and there's a lot of options, including Ryerson, U of T, and York. And as a young legislator, I was proud that the first legislation I passed was to end the longest strike at York University, which the Liberals did nothing. For the longest strike in Canadian history, we ended it in the first month of being in government last summer. So we're investing in our young people. The biggest priority for me, for young people, is getting them a decent job that has a good income. And if we could focus on incomes and better jobs, we actually could help unleash the potential in our young people. You know, when it comes to universities and colleges, my priority is making it affordable. I appreciate, you know, we want to have it in our backyards. And, you know, I think as the government has said, once we return to balance, we could actually have that conversation.
We can hope for that.
Well, I think we should have that discussion when we have a balanced budget. But for me, in the meantime, what are we doing to help young people get into college, university? Well, we cut tuition by 10%. You know, I may not be the oldest politician, but in my life on this earth, no government, including a conservative, has cut tuition rates. We're the first, not Kathleen Wynne, not Dalton McGuinty, we're the first to cut it by 10% to put $1,000 at York University for a social science degree. That's a lot of money every single year back in your pocket as a parent or as your child. And so we're doing what we can to make it affordable, but we're also having a reality that we have a massive deficit. And we have to be honest with each other. When you're spending $1 billion a month on interest alone, when the fourth largest expenditure in the budget of Ontario is interest, I mean, look, any reasonable person, it doesn't matter your politics, I think any reasonable common sense person would say, look, that's not sustainable. You cannot continue on that path. And I don't want my, you know, our children and grandchildren to have to make choices between service cuts or tax hikes because we today couldn't live within our means. So we're going to continue to invest in infrastructure so people in Brampton and Peel could get to college and universities across the GTA. We're going to continue to cut tuition and make it more accessible. And we're going to continue to invest in the people of Brampton by cutting their taxes. We think those are the responsible things to do. And we're going to continue to fight for this community because we know that there's more to do here. We know that after many years, they were ignored. And I think you've got guys like Amar Jot and Pravmeet, Pravmeet Sakaria, you know, just very decent, hardworking men who care deeply about this community. And trust me when I say they use their voice to fight for this community. So I know that they're making this community proud.
Okay, Brampton's mayor, Mr. Patrick Brown, has started a campaign along with his councillors. They're fighting for another hospital or better health services for Brampton. We know that Mr. Brown and Mr. Ford, they don't get along good with each other. So people are realizing or feeling that Brampton is suffering because of that. What do you have to say on that?
You know, we work right across party lines with municipal leaders. You know, look, it doesn't matter the politics of the municipal mayors. At the end of the day, we have a responsibility as a province to work with them in good faith.
Can we expect another hospital for Brampton in
I think future? You can expect new investments in healthcare to reduce hallway healthcare. I mean, the fact is 1,000 people today, including in Brampton, but across Ontario, are in a hallway today. That's the inherited legacy under the former government, just the broken system we inherited. And so I agree with you, we've got to do more in Brampton, across the country. And one of the first announcements we made was to put new monies into hospitals. We're expanding and retrofitting and building 60 new ones. And I know that your members are fighting hard to make those investments in Brampton.
Mr. Lecce is a very prominent, very upcoming star in the party. He's working with the Premier Doug Ford, getting lots of experience with that. Mr. Ford is having a Ford Festival very soon.
That's right, Ford Fest, his annual big barbecue. It's a free community event, family-friendly, lots of things, fun things to do for the kids. It's this Saturday, anytime after 6 p.m. at the Markham Fairgrounds. Everyone is welcome. Please register in advance, and I just want to wish you, your team, as well as all your viewers, a very happy Canada Day. Thank you for your community's contribution to building this country. We're all better off for it, and God bless. Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming to our studio.
Thank you so much.